Hello there, I'm Blackbright, broadcasting out of the UK, around the world. Welcome to my channel. If you like it, subscribe, share, and subscribe, share, and like. Yeah, those three things. First time passing through, I talk about a variety of subjects. I like to think that I am giving you information that you wouldn't normally come across. I mean, we do have the news and people can search on YouTube, but sometimes things slip through the net. And so when I do the channel, I kind of do it with you in mind and I think, oh, this is quite interesting. I wonder if this would interest my subscribers. Sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong, but it doesn't really matter. There's always somebody who will benefit from the information I give. Today now, however, space equipment. To identify immigrants, illegal immigrants. Now, you know, like in the past, border control or border patrol have had to stop lorries and search lorries in order to find out whether or not they are carrying illegal immigrants. Sometimes you get illegal immigrants under the track. Most of them are inside the canvas, but it's kind of a stop and search thing. And so a lot of illegal immigrants are still able to get into the country, because if the border patrol doesn't stop a certain lorry and that lorry has immigrants in it, that lorry gets through. And a lot of times it causes holdups and all sorts of frustration. So guess what? Astronomers have come up with this space technology that can actually identify immigrants in lorries on the move on a motorway at 100 miles an hour through thermal technology. So this equipment actually penetrates any canvas. It can't penetrate metal. So I'm not quite sure if when they go underneath a lorry, whether it can pick them up, because if underneath the lorry is metal, but I think there's always some gaps. But yeah, so what's going to happen now is that they're going to be picked up. And this thermal imaging, I'm not quite sure if it picks up the number plate of the lorry or that kind of information, but it definitely picks up illegal immigrants stored on lorries. So This technology is getting more and more sophisticated. And one thing with intelligence and curiosity is that you're always learning how to do things better, more efficiently. And this is an example. Look how they've moved from a stop and search, well, the Road Traffic Act, where they stop vehicles and they use the Police Criminal and Evidencing Act to search a lorry. Now, they don't even have to do that. They don't have to stop all the traffic. They can hone in on a particular vehicle they know has stored illegal immigrants. I mean, this technology is something else. Apparently, the body shows up as a blur, even if they've got weapons in on their body and it's hidden underneath their clothing, the equipment actually picks it up. Apparently, the body show up as a blur, and then if they have any weapons or anything, that shows up as a dark spot. And they're going to be trialing this in airports from 2021. And so, yeah, I'm going to read you out the source, and it's fascinating. Space equipment can identify illegal immigrants in lorries on the move. People smuggling scanners, which can detect illegal immigrants in lorries even when speeding along at 100 miles an hour, have been developed by scientists. Current border control officers must stop trucks if they want to check for stowaways inside, leading to lengthy delays and backlogs coming into the country. But the new system, devised by Sequestim, a spin-off venture from Cardiff University, has shown that people can be clearly identified behind the curtains of freight trucks, even when they are travelling at a speed on the motorway. The scanning camera is based on technology designed by astronomers to study far away phenomena in space. It picks up body heat and thermal signatures and is so sensitive it could spot a 100-watt light bulb at a distance of 500 thousand miles, twice the distances between Earth and the Moon. I mean, it's fascinating. The same technology is used by space agencies, including NASA, and last year helped create the most comprehensive map of the universe in the aftermath of the Big Bang. It can even locate people hidden in boxes and can show if they're carrying weapons. Our truck scanning solution is entirely new to the world and will be a great help in the fight against people smuggling and illegal immigrants, said CEO Paul Simmons. We can see what is hidden inside the trucks traveling at motorway speeds, even if people are concealed inside crates. It's quite remarkable. The new technology would allow authorities to screen vehicles without bringing them to a halt, and even screen vehicles on an open road. It has already been trialled at Cardiff Airport as a security scanner to identify concealed weapons or other dangerous items on passengers while they are still moving and wearing outer clothing. You know what just came to my mind though? What about radioactivity? I'm sure that this must have a high level of radioactivity to make it work. And how damaging is that to the people who it's focusing on? You know, or who it's targeting? I mean, are we all, as we're driving along the motorway, going to be injected with radioactivity bits and pieces, or whatever you call those bits that come out from radioactivity? I mean, they're talking about the smart meters. They're radioactive, and they were worried about people having them in their homes, and all this biometric equipment. I mean, if it's all radioactive, because they even say that, you know, like when you go to the dentist, and you know they do an X-ray, they reckon that you should ask for a throat guard, because what can happen is that you can actually develop cancer, so they say. You know, if you have a lot of X-rays in your tooth because of the radioactivity and goodness knows what. Don't take my word for it. Check it out. It's something like a throat guard, and it's something to do with your thyroid. I don't know if men and women have thyroid. Anyway, it's this area. You can actually, any person who's having an X-ray can go to the dentist and ask for a throat guard. They have them. People don't always ask for them. I mean, the X-ray is always so quick. But supposing you've got a lot of, mind you, they only do it once in a while. But anyway, as long as you know that bit. But it just came to mind when I was thinking about those scanning things and that, you know, it must work off radioactivity. Anyway, the company has been working with Security Services, Department of Transport, Ministry of Defence and Police to develop the scanners with the aim of deploying them at airports in 2021. Although the sensors cannot see through metal, they can see through the canvas sides of lorries, which account for 70% of arrivals at ports. The camera detects millimetre waves, which are just like visible light, but at a wavelength more than 1,000 times longer, said Ken Wood of Sequestim. Any items concealed beneath clothing show up very clearly as a shadow, because the human body, by dint of its heat, acts like a light bulb at these wavelengths. Unlike the scanners currently in use, our systems only need a few seconds to do its work. We plan to make the world a safer place, but we will also make the security processes quicker and less of an imposition. Yeah, like I said in one of my earlier videos, the Chinese put an exhibition on in London, central London, and they were promoting these thermal imaging techniques. Yeah, that was taken from the Telegraph. I'll put the link in the description below. But yeah, it is interesting. But like I said, all of these processes have positives and negatives. And we have to be aware that when they're using all this equipment, how is it going to impact us? How does it affect our health? And we don't even have a say because we don't even know it's happening. Just a thought, just putting it out there, just my opinion. And that's all for now. Bye-bye.